Well, first of all, many people may not know about this question of the word ECOWAS. And this is the economic community of West African states. At the moment, there are 15 of us, 15 countries, and the mandate of this organization is actually the long-term mandate is to improve the lives and the well-being of our people. Each government have their own programs, so you need an organization that will help to coordinate, to seek high degree of harmonization of policies, programs. So we have the commission, the ECOWAS Commission, to do that. And then we need organizations that will help member states execute some of the programs. And so we do have specialized agencies. We're moving towards a full integrated union where our people can cross boundaries as you do here in Europe.
C'est aussi un espace qui est en train de connaître des dynamiques très fortes, des dynamiques économiques, des dynamiques sociales, des dynamiques même comme en Europe ici, des dynamiques des enjeux de sécurité.
ECOWAS was able immediately to apply its protocols and ensure that it reversed the coup that happened. It got the coup plotters to vacate, leave the scene of the power, and put a transitional government, a government that will bring the country back to democracy and the rule of law. So thereafter, once the government was put in place, we tried to now canvass for international support, including at the United Nations, to ensure that appropriate steps were taken to, first of all, allow ECOWAS forces to go in there and ensure it stopped some of the criminal activities going on and to stop the move to divide the country into two different regions.
Chaque pays a sa façon, a sa direction d'immigration. Chaque pays. Quand vous prenez un pays comme le Mali, un pays comme le Sénégal, ils vont vers l'Europe, vers l'Amérique, vers les Golfes. Quand vous prenez un pays comme le Niger, il va au Togo, au Nigeria, au Sénégal.
Les femmes et les jeunes, vous savez, comme je l'ai dit, c'est elles qui subissent en premier lieu, ces femmes, les contraintes quand il y a les crises, quand il y a la rébellion, quand il y a les problèmes. Mais ce qu'il faut dire aussi, c'est ces acteurs-là, que sont les femmes et les enfants, surtout les jeunes, qui sont les facteurs de développement en Afrique. Mais par contre, ces femmes qui sont très actives dans les travaux de soins non rémunérés, comme on les appelle, mais aussi dans les travaux productifs, comme l'agriculture, comme le commerce, comme l'économie informelle, doivent être considérées parce que elles sont à la base de la productivité de notre économie.
One of the things we are pursuing is food security in the region. And it's only fitting that the agricultural sector is one of the main contributors to that food security. We need to have, you know, cooperation with others. No country on earth has all the resources it needs. It's only through cooperation, national and international cooperation, that we get things done. And we are very glad the Spanish cooperation is very keen in helping us doing what we have to do. And that's very interesting.
In the case of Spain, I mean, that partnership is deepened as we are right now. It is expanding and it's touching on critical areas. When you start talking about capacity building of institutions and of organizations and of individual actors, that's a major contribution. And there where we are discussing capacity building, we are also discussing the question of migration, helping our people to migrate freely within the sub-region. That goes beyond people just moving. It goes into systems, process, passports, and so forth.
Donc le fonds espagnol Migration et Développement est un fonds que nous sommes en train d'utiliser. D'abord, ce fonds nous aide à comprendre le contenu, le fondement de ces mouvements migratoires en Afrique de l'Ouest et peut-être même les sorties de l'Afrique de l'Ouest à d'autres destinations. Ça nous permet d'avoir toute l'information, de comprendre les fondements, de comprendre les enjeux et de prendre en compte les conséquences humaines, les conséquences sociales et les conséquences économiques.
Last Friday, we signed an agreement with the Spanish cooperation in terms of for agriculture, because we already engaged with the Spanish cooperation in terms of financing some of the activities related to the implementation of the agricultural policy of ECOWAS. So the Spanish cooperation is helping us manage the agency, the regional agency for agriculture and food security, which is based right now in Lome. Under the agreement, we have, the Spanish cooperation is providing us 3 experts to help, you know, evaluate the project. So that's one of the biggest chunk of this agreement. Then the second thing is that the Spanish cooperation with other partners have created what we call the donor group for ECOWAS implementation. And Spanish, the Spanish cooperation is heading that group or donors group right now. And in that framework also, we have a good understanding through the funds of the European Union